Hi everyone, we're gonna go ahead and get the live stream started. It is a hot day today here in Southern California. I think it's around 95. I decided to go ahead and live stream outside. It's a little bit breezy, but it actually has calmed down just a moment. But we may cut the live stream just a little bit short because I am already hot and sweaty. Got my water here, so I'll be drinking a lot of water throughout the live stream, but it's always fun to be outside. And I did wanna show you the cucumber plants right behind me. Because our topic today is on cucumbers, how to grow a lot of cucumbers without bitterness. And if you've ever grown cucumbers before, you might have realized that sometimes they can get kind of bitter. So that's what we're going to talk about today. But before we do, I just want to welcome you, say a happy Monday to everyone. I hope you all had a great weekend. Happy Father's Day to all you dads out there. Thank you so much for all you do. I had a nice little chat with my dad last night, and we had a great Father's Day barbecue last evening. Our daughter is out of town, but Drew was here, and we also had another friend over. And it was really nice, a nice warm evening, a beautiful evening in the garden last night. So I hope you all had a great time as well. And I just realized this morning that tomorrow is the official summer solstice, at least here in the Northern Hemisphere. So happy summer. It's crazy to think that we are now well into the summer growing season. And before you know it, you guys, it's going to be time to start our fall seeds. Can you believe that? But for now, we're going to enjoy all the summer veggies that we can. And yeah, Mac actually left inside today. It's just too hot for him out here, and I didn't want to have to worry about him, you know, getting overheated or anything like that. So he's indoors, but as usual, he will make an appearance in our videos, I'm sure, this coming weekend's video. So let me say hello to those of you that are here. I did have a couple of super chats in the pre-chat live stream, the pre-live stream chat. So thank you so much to Les Robos, I believe, and Amy Boland. I think I got your names right. If not, I apologize, but I really do appreciate the super chats. You can show your support for our channel by clicking the super chat button, and that goes to our channel and to supporting our small business. So thank you so much for that. Okay, let's say hello. My screen is dim, I think, because of the heat, so I may have to transfer over to my laptop, which is right next to me here, but it's actually kind of buffering as well, but I think we'll be okay on the screen. Les Scott, thank you so much, Cliff. Les, and thank you, Cliff, for letting me know it's Les Scott. Cliff and Nisha are our moderators today. Hello, Angela, how are you? Great to see you on here, and that reminds me that we're actually headed out to Maryland to see Gary from the Rustic Garden, and we're gonna be at a co-book signing event at Freetown Farm on Saturday, and I know Angela is going to be there as well as Jack. I don't know if he's here in the live stream today. We're looking forward to meeting those of you who have registered. It is actually a fundraising event for the community farm. Freetown Farm helps the community, feeds the community, and also has community garden plots that members of the community can rent out, or I'm not sure if they rent it out or if it's a free space for them, but they do a lot of great work for the communities, the schools, all kinds of things there. And there'll be a link for how you can sign up for that in the video description. There are only a few spots left. I wanna say maybe 5 or 6 spots. Very limited parking, so we are doing a morning session, afternoon session, little garden chat. There's a plant sale as well. And then Gary and I will be doing a co-book signing. So if you haven't signed up for that and you live out in the Washington, DC, Maryland, Baltimore area, do make sure you sign up because we're really looking forward to seeing you there. I'm trying to get used to the hot weather. It's going to be humid while we're there. It's about 95 here today, but it's only 12% humidity. And for those of you on the East Coast, you know there's a huge difference when you're dealing with 90 or 95% humidity, and I'm not used to that. So it'll be a really fun time. Camera guy is going to be there as well. We're going to be filming in Gary's garden, maybe do a garden tour of some kind, some other videos, and maybe filming some things for Gardening Coast to Coast. Who knows? So we're really, really looking forward to it. Okay, Santa Ana Road Wildman, wow, you're here today. Are you off for the holiday? But it's great to see you here. Angela, only 78. Wow, nice day there. I fingers crossed that the weather stays that cool, but I think it's supposed to heat up. Julia from North Carolina, great to have you. Cree's Crazy Life. growing munchers and lemon cukes on the same trellis. That's perfectly okay. Laura, great to see you here. Long Island is finally getting some warmish weather. That's great. Hopefully you can get your summer garden growing along and lots of good tomatoes and cucumbers. Okay, we're gonna jump right into the tips today. First tip on growing cucumbers in the summer heat and avoiding them being bitter. Okay, I've got these cucumbers right behind me here, guys, and some of the leaves are getting a little bit spotted. Heat, there's a few leaf miners on them, but I'm still getting tons of cucumbers off them. And you can see my first tip here is to grow them vertically. Definitely grow them vertically. They're a vining vegetable. You can grow them sprawling if you have the space. And actually, when we were out at Gary's last year at the community farm, they are growing some sprawling. I think we might have done a video on that and posted it. But most people don't have the space for that. And even if you do, I really enjoy growing them vertically because it keeps them up off the ground, provides better airflow under the plant. Generally speaking, keeps the plant healthier, a little bit farther away from the critters and the bugs, but they can still climb their way up, unfortunately. But the main thing is it just keeps them up off the ground, keeps your garden looking neater and tidier, and just keeps the leaves drier so that they don't get powdery mildew, because that's a big, big problem with cucumbers is powdery mildew. And if you've never had that, number one, you're lucky, but most gardeners get it at some point in the growing season. So if you do get it, it doesn't mean you do anything wrong. It just kind of happens at some point. And it's kind of like a powdery substance is poured all over the leaves of your plants. It kind of looks like baby powder. There's a milk spray that you can apply, and I've got a video on that, which you can look up on my channel. Just look up powdery mildew and that should pop up. But really the key is keeping your plants healthier, because healthier plants are going to be a lot less susceptible to stress, to stressing out in a heat wave like we have today. When they're less stressed, they're less likely to be bitter. So the first thing I always, always recommend is to grow them vertically. And there's so many amazing, very easy trellises that you can grow. I have three or maybe five types of DIY trellises in my new book on raised bed gardening. We built one or two on the raised bed garden series. This one is one of my favorites. It's actually in my book as well. It's a teepee trellis. This is actually made, not a teepee trellis, it is a teepee trellis. It's made out of sunflower stalks, and it's just tied at the top with twine to kind of keep it all together, and then you just kind of fan it out in your container or your garden bed. This one is actually growing in a little shorty, and if you guys have not grown in little shorties, you've got to grab one over at CaliKimGardenHome.com. This, seriously, you guys, is a growing machine. Everything I've planted in little shorty just grows amazing. It's a 3-foot smart pots raised bed, and it is just a really cool little raised bed to add and expand your garden space. But the cucumbers are growing in it. I've got a pepper growing in it, a tiny Tim tomato here. I just picked my first few little tiny Tims over the weekend. You might have seen my Instagram post. We had a really nice garden fresh omelet for Father's Day I made for Jerry. Some tiny Tims were in there as well. And you can grab all of my Smart CaliKim Smart Pots for 15% off with the code SQUASH right now over at CaliKimGardenHome.com. So tip number one, grow vertically. Okay, I did see questions scrolling by here. I think someone said, okay, Chris, hi, how are you doing today? Can you trim the vines? And if you can, how? You absolutely can. I actually went through here yesterday and trimmed off a whole bunch of leaves. Because there were some spotted leaves, I didn't want the disease spreading to the rest of the plant, especially since we're getting ready to head out to Maryland. So I just went through, there's some spotted ones here, but I went through and trimmed off the worst of the spotted leaves, and I just cut them right at the stem here. And if there's any stray stems that just really won't fit in the space, a lot of times I try and tie them up, but it's okay if you cut like a lateral stem to your cucumbers. It's not going to hurt it. I don't tend to heavily prune cucumbers. I know some people might do that for, you know, more production. I just don't really have the time to keep up with that, but that's certainly an option. But mainly just trim off the leaves that aren't looking so good. Okay, let's see what other questions are coming along here. Ramona, how are you doing today? I have mammoth sunflowers growing. I hope they make it. Sunflowers can really take the heat and take the drought. So they're super easy to grow. So my thought is that they probably most likely are gonna make it. You might have seen on my last month's garden tour, my sunflower forest. Let's see if we can get any shots. See, I've got my shade cloth up right over there because of the heat. I don't know if the sunflower forest will show. Oh, there it is. There's a couple sunflowers just starting to bloom in the sunflower forest. So super excited about that. They really take the heat like crazy. The funny thing is, we were sitting out here last night, and when we started our evening, there was no sunflowers blooming. By the end of the evening, there was one that had opened up. So that was pretty exciting because I've really only seen them open up like in the morning. So it was kind of cool to all of a sudden look over there and a sunflower was open. So yeah, Santa Ana Road Wild Man, that is probably, I want to say these are all volunteers. I want to say they're probably at least double my height. I'm 5'8", and I want to say they're well over 12 feet tall, maybe even taller. So we'll definitely do an update. A lot is growing and looking really beautiful in the garden right now. We will do an updated July garden tour in a couple of weeks, so do stay tuned for that. Let's see here, question, where did that go here? Oh, do you prefer normal cukes or F1 hybrids? You know what? Doesn't matter to me, as long as they are cucumbers that I can eat, as long as they're tasty and fresh, I'll eat them. So I do have a couple of favorite varieties, which I'll talk about in just a moment. Okay, let's go back to our tips. Tip number two, and that is, do make sure for cucumbers to grow a lot, make sure that you keep them well watered and fertilized, especially when they're in this stage right here. See how there are little cucumbers all over the plant here? There's this one here, there's one down here. I don't know if you guys can see that. It was in my Instagram photo this morning. And there's lots of little baby ones. This one did not get pollinated. It's drying up, probably will fall off. But up at the top, there's tons of little baby cucumbers and baby flowers there. So, or flowers there. So when they're flowering and fruiting, don't let them dry out. Give them a good dose of fertilizer. The worm tea is a really good thing to add to your plants at this point in the growth. Just keeps them healthy, keeps them well watered, gives them all that good beneficial bacteria and microbes, keeps them producing. And you don't want them to dry out, because when they dry out, again, they get stressed. And that's the biggest thing to why you would have bitter cucumbers, is when your plants get stressed. So keep your soil nice and moist. Make sure that your containers, if you're are growing in containers, are don't dry out. When they dry out even one time, it can really stunt your plants. So if you can, install drip irrigation in your containers. It's really not as hard as you think, and that way your plants get water consistently. And that's very, very helpful to producing cucumbers that are nice and sweet and juicy and refreshing on a hot summer's day, just like today is. I actually just harvested one yesterday here, and I plan on putting this on my salad for lunch. And yes, oh, I forget who said that, Cree's Crazy Life. I forget where that was there. They are definitely heavy feeders. They have a mostly water content. So you definitely need to keep them well watered, keep them well fertilized. Kathleen says, do you fertilize with good dirt liquid fertilizer or worm tea? At this point in the growing season, I tend to use worm tea because the good dirt fertilizer is high in nitrogen, which I kind of want to encourage fruiting and flowering right now, not necessarily leafy growth. However, once I go through and harvest the crop that is currently on the vine, or if I do a heavy pruning, I will do a good dirt plant food because it's higher in nitrogen, and that way it brings back lots of good green leafy growth to the plant. But usually I'll do like the worm tea right about now. I might put some extra compost around the stem of the plant, and I might add on some worm castings too. So that's always a great idea. Now, if you need cucumber seeds, a lot of you are growing with my cucumber seed collection. Whoops. And this is a really great collection, you guys. It has 5 different varieties. A lot of my favorites in here. And this one is, I think this one is a Market Mora or a Space Master. I can't remember. They all kind of look very, very similar. The Poinsett is a really good one as well. The Space Master is a little bit smaller of a variety, great for containers like Smart Pots. or other types of containers if you want a smaller type of space. Lemon cucumber, you guys, is one of my favorites. I think someone mentioned they were growing lemon cucumbers. They look like little tiny lemons. Well, not even tiny lemons, like medium-sized lemons. They taste like cucumbers, but they're really beautiful and pretty. One of my favorite varieties and super productive is the Boston pickling cucumber. Which is in here somewhere, but I tend to grow lots and lots of these. All of these are great for just munching on, snacking on in the garden for fresh eating. And the Boston pickling is particularly good for pickling. I don't make a lot of pickles, but I love the Boston pickling cucumber. They're super, super tasty, sliced up, and we eat cucumbers quite a bit just fresh. I make a Greek yogurt herbed dip that we like to dip them in, put them in my water. Usually I have a lot of cucumbers, so there's lots and lots of different ways you can eat them. So I would love to hear more about how you like to eat them as well. Japanese long cucumber is a really delicious cucumber. And Angela, we're going to answer your question in just a minute. Okay, so hang on to that. Is it too late to start new cucumbers from seed? Rod, how are you? It's great to have you here today. Always good to see you on. And V says she's growing the lemon cucumber. They're really fun cucumbers. I've got some right behind me here where I showed you where all the shade cloth is. They're looking really, really good, and I did not want them getting messed up by our 95 degree day. So those will keep shaded while we're in Maryland. Okay, is it fine? This is from Montana. Bean Blossom, how are you doing today? Is it fine to plant cucumbers and pole beans on the same trellis? Absolutely. There's no reason why you can't plant them together. I don't think I have any right now. But yeah, there's no reason why you couldn't do that. You could put, here's this teepee trellis here. You could put cucumbers on one of the little legs and then to do pole beans or the scarlet runner beans on another one of the legs. They're gonna grow just fine together, and it'll you know, really flower and bring in the pollinators. Now, one thing, thank you so much, Crazy Life says, I have to say, I really love your channel. Thank you, I really appreciate that. Thanks for being here today. One thing that I have found that brings in the pollinators like crazy is the scarlet runner beans. So that would be a great thing to plant with cucumbers. Those are in my bean seed collection. I have a whole bunch planted at the top of the hill, and it has brought in the hummingbirds and the bees like crazy. They just started blooming maybe 2 weeks ago, and I cannot believe the increase in the garden of the pollinators this year. It's just absolutely amazing. We're having so much fun watching them in the evenings when we sit outside. Okay, let's see. Kim P, how are you? Great to have you on here as always, watching from the Virgin Islands, hot and humid. Yeah, so hopefully you're able to stay cool. Andrea, I tried growing lemon cucumbers last year. They were not productive and the only plant that got mildew. Well, you know what? Different cucumbers grow differently in different areas. So if those didn't work for you in your area, then just grow the ones that worked best for you. And you know, I always say there's 1,000 ways to do things. And always experiment, see what works best for you, and then just go for it. Okay, Jackie, how are you? Great to see you on here today too. And I appreciate you joining us today. Tammy, how are you doing? Do you pick off cucumbers that grow too soon when the plant is small? You can definitely do that to help your plant get a little bit bigger. If it's at the seedling stage, like 2 or 3 inches tall, probably a good idea to go ahead and pinch off the blossoms if there's any fruit developing, because you want all the plant's energy to go into producing fruit, into producing leaves, not necessarily flowers. Okay, or not necessarily flowers and fruit. All right, tip number 3 is you want to shade your cucumbers in hot weather. Okay, we've talked about this a lot in our live streams and in our videos, but a lot of people going through hot temperatures lately. The temperatures are just all over the board. And when the temperatures swing from, like Cliff had in the 30s last weekend, or last week, can you believe that? And then the next day in the 90s. So those temperature swings tend to stress the plants out. When a plant gets stressed, what they do is, especially when it gets over 90, the flowers tend to dry up and drop off. Now, this little cucumber right here did not get pollinated, but hot temperatures, the flowers will dry up, drop off, and then you kind of have to start all over. Your cucumbers that are on the vine tend to get stressed, might turn yellow, which is either a sign of them overgrowing or getting too big, or a sign of heat. So when it gets, oh, here comes the wind. Hopefully we're okay for a little bit. When it gets over 90, I like to shade my plants. I will probably shade this one when we're done live streaming. Right now I have an umbrella up, but the cucumbers that are behind me I showed you, I shaded early this morning around 8 o'clock. Cucumbers do okay in the heat, but not the super hot temperatures. So if you want to grow a lot of cucumbers, shade them in the hot weather. Now I did bring a couple of pieces of shade cloth with me today because some people have never used shade cloth. There's different types or different, I guess you would say, thicknesses or different UV blocks. This one, you can see how it's a little bit looser of a weave. You can still see through it. So the plant still does get sun. I want to say this is probably around a 40% shade cloth. And these are all available on Amazon. I've got links in the video description. This one here is a tighter weave. This is what I used on the cucumbers uphill from me. This is a lighter color shade cloth, and I want to say it's about a 60% weave. So if you're getting lots and lots of hot weather or consistent hot weather like I know Patricia gets up or down in Arizona, you may want to consider going with a tighter weave shade cloth to keep your plants a little bit more cooler. ALW is asking, can you purchase shade cloth at the thrift store, fabric store? I've never seen actual shade cloth at the fabric store, but you can probably get things like sheer curtains, that type of thing, or sheer curtain material. It's you know, not going to do quite the same, but it will help cover your plants, you know, in the shade if that's, you know, what works best for you. Marie, thank you so much for the $15 super chat. We missed you while you were gone. Happy to be back at the live stream. Thanks for all your advice and help save my cucumbers growing vertically. Shade your garden. Okay, Marie, thank you so much. I appreciate it. We love your support. I know you've purchased lots of things from our seed shop, and you're always so positive and encouraging and here on the live streams almost every week. So glad you're back, and thanks for the super chat. Shade cloth will help your plants not be stressed during the heat, help you avoid that bitter flavor that they do tend to get when they get too hot. Now, I do have a couple of videos. Oh, the other thing you want to do is mulch at the bottom. So I am doing so much mulch this year because of our, you know, we're not able to water as much this year. So I've got a couple inches right here of the shredded straw, and I get this over at Epic Gardening. But if you have shredded leaves, I'm kind of running out of leaves at this point, but if you have shredded leaves, you can definitely use that. Save all of your fall leaves once it turns into fall, and you can use them in your garden. They have tons of uses. Or you can buy like a bale of straw at the feed store that's not shredded up. It's a little bit harder to apply, but that's definitely an option. It's very inexpensive. Or a lot of people use the shaved, what are they called? I always forget what they're called. The pet bedding that you can buy like at the pet store. That's a good option as well, but it will really help reduce your watering needs, will help keep the soil damp, especially in containers, because they do dry out so fast in the hot weather. So mulch is absolutely key during a heat wave. I would be absolutely lost without it. So if you're in Southern California, experiencing all the water restrictions that we have right now, do make sure you grab yourself some shade cloth. It's a worthy investment. It will last you for years. I've had the same shade cloth for probably 3 to 5 years. And then I pick up some clips. Yes, you can use pine needles for mulching. That's a great option as well. I pick up some clips like on Amazon. Let's see what kind of clips I have that I can show you guys. I use those little binder clips quite a bit. I don't have one within reach. You can grab those like at the office supply store, and then just clips, you know, any kind of jaw clips that you can get on Amazon or at your hardware store. They are a little bit expensive at the hardware store, so I would suggest that you try and purchase them on Amazon or somewhere else. Shade cloth is available just about everywhere. The garden center, I have links in the video description on what I use. It's an Amazon link that you can grab, but it is readily available in most places. In a pinch, you can use like an old bed sheet if you don't have anything else or don't want to invest in shade cloth or don't have the budget for that. Okay, so let's see what questions we have before we go back to our tips. Got two more tips left for you, and we're going to answer some of the questions that were asked earlier in the live stream. Okay, Black binder clips work best for me. Yeah, and they're super inexpensive. I think you can get a pack of like 20 or something for maybe $5 or something like that. So they are relatively inexpensive. JT Bivens, how do you clean bird poop off your veggies? I pretty much throw my veggies once I bring them into the house before I refrigerate them. If I'm gonna use them right away, well, let me back up. I pretty much clean everything in a sink full of, with a maybe a half a cup or a fourth a cup of vinegar. Kills any creepy crawlies that might be on it, and will definitely take care of the bird poop. Usually I will rinse something like that off first before I put it in the water, but that will definitely help disinfect it. But a lot of vegetables I don't wash until I use them. So things like cucumbers, like this little baby right here, what's gonna make it spoil is excess moisture. So I'll wrap it in a paper towel, stick it in the fridge. It will last up to a week that way because the paper towel will absorb the moisture, or you can use like a tea cloth or a dishcloth, something like that. And then once I take it out of the fridge to eat it, I will wash it and, you know, then just set it on the counter to dry until I eat it. So works very, very well. Okay, let's move on here to our next tip here. And that is what some people don't realize is that cucumbers, to grow a lot in your garden, cucumbers are a vegetable that you can plant all summer long. Right now is the perfect time to plant more cucumbers. The soil is warm. They're going to grow very, very fast. You can pop them in the soil and then they will germinate within a couple of days. Grab yourself a couple of the CaliKim Smart Pots while they're on sale right now for 15% off with the code SQUASH. I don't remember if I mentioned that earlier. And just pop some in a container. Plant the seeds every couple of weeks. That way, like these will be probably dying off maybe within another month or so because of the heat, because of bugs, because of powdery mildew, because for whatever reason. And I'll have some brand new cucumbers to take their place. So that way you don't run out of cucumbers to harvest. So now's a great time just about anywhere that you can plant new cucumber seeds. Now I do have a special seed collection that I designed just for this purpose. And it's called, yes, it is, Sherry. You can plant whatever varieties you want. Doesn't matter if they're in the same container, same garden bed. You can mix and match to your heart's content. But I did design a variety or a seed collection, especially for planting right now. It's called the Late Summer Garden Seed Collection. There's 7 varieties in here. And these are some of my favorites that are easy to grow veggies. So it really takes the guesswork out of it. It makes it easy for you. It's a great opportunity to grab this with a 15% off sale. And there's some beans in here, which grow fast. The Tiny Tim tomato, my favorite. Some basil, cucumbers, a squash, and the Lilliput zinnia. So these are all varieties that grow fast, grow from seed to harvest in about 6 to 8 weeks. So that way you can get a second wave of vegetables going and take care of when these die out, you're gonna have some backups and more cucumbers in place. Because nothing worse than getting to August and you have no veggies. So because all your veggies have died by then because of heat or because of whatever reason. And a lot of times it's so much easier to start with a fresh vegetable rather than try and save a vegetable plant that might be kind of struggling. So grab this and that way you will be all ready to go with a second wave, ready to harvest in probably, you know, beginning of July, end of July. And even in California here, I often plant these in August because we have hot weather into November and December. And I usually plant 2 or 3 waves of these quick growing vegetables so I don't run out of stuff late in the season. So you gotta think ahead a little bit and have backups going. Now, when you are planting, if you don't have space in your garden, what you can do is you can start from seed indoors if you want to. If you have the space and wanna get your grow lights all going again, definitely you can do that. But what I like to do too, is I have, thank you, Patricia. She has the Late Summer Garden Seed Collection. She's grown with my seed in my seed shop for years, and I really appreciate that. But if you don't have space in your garden, I have a shelf set up on the side of my house. And at this time of the year, what I do is I just set up my flats with my seed starting mix and just pop seeds in there. It gets morning sun only. Keep it well watered. You don't wanna have it in the hot sun all day long because it'll just kind of fry those little 6-packs. But start your seeds the same way you would indoors, but just put your flats outside somewhere where they get morning sun and afternoon shade. And then that way, as soon as your old crop here is ready to go, ready to pull out, you'll have fresh new transplants to take their place. And these you can hold in the seed flats and grow in the seed flats for about 4 weeks. So it'll be perfect timing, start some now, and when these are done, I'll have new transplants to take their place. So just kind of think ahead a little bit. You might want to try that, especially with beans, squash, and cucumbers. That way you'll have some veggies going, and believe me, in about a month, you're gonna thank me for this, okay? So grab one of these today with the code SQUASH, 15% off. And while you're at it, you could grab one of the CaliKim 5 gallons or the 10 gallons, which would be perfect for growing any of those vegetables. You might wanna put squash though in a 10 gallon. A 5 gallon's a little bit small for squash. And then grab your signed copy of my new book as well. There's actually a really great chart in here that will be a great resource for you later in the summer, or any time really, but it is all on, got a great one on plant spacing, how you can space plants in a raised bed. And then there is a succession planting chart as well, which is something really important to consider at this point in the growing season, because there's lots and lots of vegetables that you can succession plant or plant at intervals so you can spread the harvest out and so you don't run out of vegetables to harvest. And as you grow throughout your growing garden life, a garden career, if you want to call it that, you're going to learn which vegetables you enjoy succession planting and work well for you as far as that goes. Okay, let's see here if there's some comments or questions in the chat. Miriam, thank you so much. I love how you group your seeds in packets, which helps us new gardeners. I have bought a couple of sets. Really appreciate it, Miriam. And that was kind of my goal when I started, is that I really wanted to make it easy for people, especially new gardeners, because when you get out there, you're like, what the heck am I supposed to plant? And the seed collections really take the guesswork out of it. Would you believe, you guys, I started the seed collections, I want to say about 5 years ago. And Marilyn, it already is in ebook form. It's in Kindle form on Amazon. You can check that out. But I started my seed shop about 5 years ago with just 5 seed collections. And over the years, it's grown to 30. Thanks to all of your suggestions, I add new ones every single year. So just about anything you want to grow, lots of vegetables, watermelon, fruit, tons and tons of flowers, maybe 7 or 8 flower seed collections. One of my favorites this year is the Raised Bed Kitchen Garden Seed Collection. It has lots of different varieties in here. I want to say there's 19. They're 15 or 19, I forget. So it's a good all-around variety to pick up if you want lots of different types of vegetables but don't want to buy a lot of different seed collections. So thanks to those of you who support our seed shop. Okay, let's see here. I saw a question. How am I keeping your cukes watered with the water restrictions? Denise, there is not as many restrictions in most areas, either when you hand water or when you use drip irrigation. So check out your local city for the restrictions. Drip irrigation is a low flow system, low pressure system. The water restrictions are mainly on watering lawns with like a regular old sprinkler that evaporates into the air. So check your local restrictions. I also use tons of mulch, which means I don't have to water as often. Or with my containers, I will put them in a tub of water to soak the water up from the bottom. And that way the water is fully saturated and you won't have to water as often. I do have several container watering videos on my container garden series, so do check those out as well. Okay, I saw another question scroll through here. I don't see it. So we're gonna move on to, oh, and before I forget, you guys, believe it or not, the 4th of July is in, I want to say 2 weeks from today, which is crazy. It's a Monday, so we're not going to live stream on the 4th of July. So just keep that in mind. And I hope y'all have a wonderful 4th with your family. But next week, special live stream. You definitely want to stay tuned. Oh, a butterfly just flew by. It's beautiful. A special live stream. We're going to be at the Rusted Garden Homestead, which is Gary's channel. A lot of you watch his channel too. If you guys watch his channel, you know how amazing his garden is. So we're going to be there for the book signing event, not at his farm, but at a different farm. And we're going to be filming lots of content while we're there, but we will be live streaming next week. Same time, noon Pacific time, Gary at Gary's Garden. Don't want to miss it. Gary will be on the live stream with me. It's going to be a ton of fun. So if you come to any live streams this summer, make sure that you make next Monday's live stream, still at noon Pacific time. It's going to be a lot of fun. Don't want to miss it. Okay, let's make sure. I know I had announced. Oh, you know what? I was so shocked the other day. I put a video up on TikTok. If you guys don't know, I have a TikTok. I just started actually not too long ago, CaliKim29. So if you're on TikTok, please go over and follow me. A lot of you made comments on a video I posted, I believe it was late last week, that you had no idea I was on TikTok. I keep forgetting to mention it. So I do post over there, so do make sure you go over there. Give me a follow if you haven't yet, share the content, and we'll be definitely posting more on there in the weeks ahead. But I'd love to see you over on TikTok as well as here on YouTube. Okay, so let's move on to our tip number five, because I'm getting really, really hot. Okay, tip number five is to harvest your cucumbers young. And I think that, is it Senja that was here earlier in the live stream, was saying one of my tips was gonna be harvest often and harvest them young. And that is so true. You must have read my notes. But you wanna, when they start producing like this, like this one's getting actually a little bit too large. I definitely need to harvest it today. You wanna check your cucumbers daily because they grow very, very fast. In fact, I think I'm gonna go ahead and pick this one now. When you harvest your cucumbers, you don't just wanna yank them from the vine. You wanna hang onto the vine. Then I like to either have a little pair of pruners or just kind of snip them off or just kind of twist them off right here. Be very gentle because you can break the vine very, very easily. Usually we'll snip them off. And this one is maybe just a tad on the large side. I do like to harvest them young. For the reason is they have the best flavor. When they get overgrown, the ends tend to get a little bit bitter. Often the bitterness is concentrated at the ends. So a lot of times you can cut off the ends and the middle will be nice and sweet. Or I know there's a little tip, is that you put salt on it or you rub the bitter end to the sweet end. I'm not sure exactly what that is, but a lot of times if you cut the ends off, the center will be great. Now, when you let them go too long, I'm gonna show you one here. Where did my really big one go? Oh, here it is. I missed this one. I did not see it. It was kind of lying in the bottom of the container and it got massive. Okay, rub salt on both the ends. Thank you for that, Nisha. And this is what happens when they get too big or when they get too hot. They get like this, okay? Now, this is not gonna be any good for eating. And I was gonna actually cut it open and show you guys why. The seeds do tend to get quite large. I'm actually gonna try this and see how it tastes. And they get pretty bitter. You know what? Actually, surprisingly, it's not too bad. It's a lot sweeter than I thought. So maybe I'll chop this up for a salad for dinner, but I betcha the end would be pretty bitter. But anyway, they're a lot better if you harvest them young. And do check them every day and just try and keep up with it if you can. Now they do produce a lot. Save the seeds, you absolutely can save the seeds. I'm probably gonna eat this one. I could scoop the seeds out and save the seeds, but I have so many seeds because I have seeds in my seed shop, so I don't really need to save the seeds, but it will make, you could definitely scoop the seeds out and just eat the flesh. This would be great in a smoothie, delicious in a smoothie. Never had cucumber smoothies, they're amazing. Or you can stick it in your water to flavor your water. But usually what I tend to do is I'm giving cucumbers away to a lot of the neighbors. I send some home with whoever happens to stop by. The cucumbers are constantly going out the door, or I bring them if I'm going to visit someone, they go with me. So yeah, we're always giving them away as much as we possibly can, which is really fun because then you get to share your love of gardening with other people. And Rod, I love your suggestion. Some lime and pepper flakes will fix that bitter flavor. Absolutely. Angela, no, the larger seeds won't necessarily produce larger fruit. So that's not really, that won't really happen from that. Like I said, this is a Boston pickling, which is an heirloom. And what you do to save the seeds is you would just kind of rinse them off, dry them like on a paper towel, make sure they're completely and totally dry. And then you can just bag them up or even put them in a paper bag so any moisture that comes in will get absorbed by the paper bag. And then you're good to go for planting for next year. So that is, oh, and if you're not sure how big your cucumber is supposed to be, just Google it, look up the variety that you're growing, see the butterfly, see what the optimal size is for the variety. Usually, I would pick them when they're probably just a little bit bigger than this. I picked this one early because I wanted to show you guys it today on the live stream, but the Boston pickling, I might pick just a tad larger than this. But just check and see, and then you might want to just try a couple different, picking them at a couple different sizes so you can see which size you like them the best and you know, how you like to eat them. So guys, I am actually going to wrap up for today. Super hot out here, head inside, but don't forget to tune in next week. We'll be at the Rustic Garden Homestead on the 27th at noon Pacific time, and then head over to CaliKimGardenHome.com, 15% off all week long with the code SQUASH. Oh, and I forgot to mention, you get a free kale seed packet with your purchase, so you can keep on growing your heat tolerant greens even during the summer. All right, guys, we'll see you later. Have a great rest of your week.